been working through it because we've got deadlines we got to meet. We got the profilers that came in this last week and profiled a couple of roads. We've been working up on the Osceola Road and Redfield Road. We changed to about 15, 16 pipes, and we have about 7,000 tons of pipe four up there in the last 5 weeks. We stockpiled all the material just to be more effective. It's too far to haul it from Barrett's, as we were putting it down, so we did stockpiles and then we could short haul it from there to the road job if we needed it. See here, this rock was in the edge of the shoulder of the snow road, and one of the plows kept hitting with the wing, wanted to know if we could get it out of there. It's just a small rock, but, so we got it out and we wiggled it out into the field, the farmer's field, and you can see it's about 6 foot tall, about 10 feet long, and about 4 or 5 feet wide. We couldn't budge it any further, so John's out there drilling me 3 holes in it that day. He's looking at me saying, "How much more, boss?" So, he got it drilled, and I blasted it a couple of weeks later, so we can handle it with the loader. We got it moved in, it's gone. This is the Redfield Road. You can see the existing black top here on this side. And it's worn, it's beaten in. So we did a reprofile job on it. And this truck right here, you'll see it probably in the next, I don't know if you see it now, but there's a drag box right behind it. And we put out like 3 inches of inch and a half of crushed gravel right out on top of the blacktop. It makes a nice even. And then right along behind that comes the grinder. And I wanted to have you see this because we strike the trailer right in front of the grinder. And we're adding oil into the mix as we're grinding it in. The grinder is mixing down into the roadbed right there it is. It's mixing the blacktop down in about 5 inches, grinding up the existing blacktop, and then grinding the 3 inches that we put in on top and adding 1.8 gallons per ton of oil into the mix just to hold it together. And it'll set for about 3 weeks before we pull over the top and do a cold mix 3 inch paving over the top. So that's the Redfield. This is one of the culvert pipes we changed. Matter of fact, this one's on the Osceola Road right at the Beagle Club. It was right on top of the hill kinda. And John, myself, and Frank, we got there and talked about it. It really wasn't doing much. Like I say, it was at the kind of peak of the hill. There was a ditch over here that was all, it really wasn't ditched all very well. And originally the water ran across and sat over there and started. Area it just wasn't getting away. So we came up with the idea of ditching it down this way and went down and over to the right. There was another runoff that went to. So we deleted this whole pipe, dug it out, got rid of it. And if you see, we did one side of the road first and keep one lane open and then dug this side. On this side, you can see it right there is the telephone cable. And they are we tried to dig them up by hand first and find them, locate them. That's the problem that we do. And you see the water that's in there. After we dug it all out, cleaned it out, we got rid of the water, we filled it all back in with crushed gravel. And you can see this black, that's a road fabric that we use. We put the road fabric down to help stabilize the roadbed. It helps clean it way better than crushed gravel on top. This is the Lions Falls job, and again, it's a reprofile job. It's a little bit different. The roadbed on this one needs a little bit more work. We wanted to grind up the existing blacktop and use it as the base, so we did the same thing. This is the drag box that we talked about. Put it right on the back of the truck, and it lays out 3 inches of crushed gravel on top of the existing blacktop. Then the grinder comes through. Again, grinds down into the existing 5 inches of blacktop. The 3 inches that we put on it, mix it together. This we did a dry grind to it. We call it a dry grind because there's no oil going in. And when we get a grader comes along behind the back of it, shakes the road, levels it back out, and then we sprayed calcium chloride on top of it, tighten it up. And we're going out next week, at least we think that, and adding some more crushed gravel to some of the bad lower spots and cleaning up the Market Bridge. Probably a lot of you heard about the red flag on it. This bridge is scheduled for replacement next year in the spring. We're going up to bid this fall for it. We choose our contractor and we'll be doing the first thing in the spring through the summer months. So it'll be down all next summer pretty much. DOT comes around and checks pretty much every bridge every year. This one deteriorated more than what they figured. They red tagged it. And the reason they red tagged it is this right here. You can see this I-beam. This is all rotted through. Now that was rotted through last year when we checked it and we looked at it. And they said it would be all right to get through the spring. But when I checked it here this spring, see how this bends down? Mm-hmm. The weight coming over it just went down. So it started giving away. So what we ended up doing, narrowing it up to one lane for now to handle the weight going on it, still allowing traffic through. And after school gets out, our plan is to go back and right over this top of this beam, we're going to cut all these short sleepers over the top. And then you can see it's open bed, deck. We're going to cut through that over the top of this beam and over the second beam over here. And right in the middle here, we've got used beams that we've taken out of other bridges that we saved. We're going to put one here and one on the other side of this beam. And that should be sufficient to carry the load for the rest of this summer and through the winter. I'm working with DOT and I'm working with Matt Sculio, who's our partner in the engineer. Right now we're trying to decide whether two is going to be sufficient or whether we're going to put the third one in. So in the next couple of weeks, we're going to shut this down. We're going to go in and do that repair, put the extra beams in, and hopefully it's going to be down like 2 weeks. And we can get it back open up for the rest of the summer and winter to be open. Didn't really want to shut this bridge down for the rest of the summer and all winter. And then be shut down all next summer yet too for the repairs. So we're putting a little bit of work in it, just trying to get it open so we get all the traffic going over it. And then we'll see some fire trucks and whatnot.
Is that where the road's lying right in that area?
It comes down, it's just before the Fish Creek Road intersection. It comes down
right,
a little.
One veers off and it keeps going straight.
Yeah. And there's it comes down a little grade right to it. So it's kind of a tough spot. You're coming down onto it, you're kind of. So hopefully, I'm talking to Dean, that's the plan we're looking at, and we think maybe 2 weeks we'll be able to get this back opened up and carrying the weight so everybody can drive on it again, and because we've still got the Liberty Road bridge to do. That's an open deck, the same way we're replacing the bridge deck, the beams, and we're raising it up a little bit so we have more work there to do. We'll still continue to do that bridge this summer too. And it might, if it does run a little bit into the open season with the school opening, it would only be probably a week that we'd have to detour the buses around, but we've got a detour set up if we have to. So. This is a DMV parking lot that we worked on this spring. This is a DMV building here. This is what it replaced the river street. More than double, I would say, wouldn't you, Matt?
Yeah, definitely.
And then the next picture is looking towards East State Street. We dug out all the grass and the subsoil that wasn't even good that would pump up through. And you can see the roll of fiber paper, road fabric that we rolled that out all across here, and we put 12 inches of crushed gravel over the top. It should make a really nice. And like I say, we just did a little work there to do right out here with this driveway without the River Street. We're going to take 6 feet of the curb out, we're going to widen that out to probably 20 feet. We've got to dig in a little bit because that subsoil was very good. We're going to replace it and finalize everything there. We hope to get to that. What do you think, Frank, next week? So that'll take care of that. I think that's the last slide.
When we do that stuff, I mean, that's a private owner. Do you work out where some of the money we put in to get credit for the rent?
property knowing that we'd have to make improvements in order for it to work for us.
Well, but this is not giving a hard time.
Right.
This is just a temporary thing. So why are we doing that? And originally, this whole project was supposed to be about $3,500. Where are we at right now? Did anybody know what we spent?
Well, this was just manpower. In terms of materials, it wasn't that much because it's just stone, basically.
But when we're making it, in the contracts, we ought to see if we can.
No, I agree.
Credit for that stuff in the future.
I agree. I don't know why we didn't look at that.
I'm just asking.
Year. No, we should have by committee. So I thought we talked about this in committee, though, didn't we? About the parking lot project.
I'm not sure about that.
I don't think
there was a dollar value added to it. I'm pretty sure of that.
But anyways, not to change the
if
we can look at something for the future. And then I guess the other thing, talking to committee, this is just kind of quick. Is there potentially stuff you've got going, like profiling, hot mix, cold mix, that we could do a tour? Because probably some of these legislators haven't seen it, or they might want to see it again.
Mm-hmm.
And pretty much anybody, any legislator wants to go.
The Lane Smalls job is on ground. We're going to put the crushed gravel on. That will be a cold mix job. It would be somewhat close by.
Otherwise, we've got to take you to Osceola.
Yeah.
Well, you're going to be milling now, aren't you?
We're going to be milling on the intersection right in
the first
Osceola.
That's coming up 25 miles.
That's in place recycling, and that'll be done the week of July 8th.
Let's set something up. I'll work with these guys. Maybe we can do a day where you could hit a couple things at the same time.
Yeah.
And we could go, see what they're doing at Lions Falls and then see what they're doing in Osceola and then stop at a bridge. I think the bridge stuff is fascinating. The stuff our bridge crew does is very impressive. So that would be a good thing to see as well.
Yeah, and if you could let all legislators know, or Larry, so you could let everybody know. And
sure.
We'll try to make
it. And the Osceola road's going to be the train job. It's where they bring in the grinder and it picks it up.
That's fascinating. I've seen it before, but what surprises me is right next to it, you'd figure it'd be making such a noise you couldn't stand it. It's amazing how quiet it is.
Yeah.
Joel would probably like to go on that one. She likes to go there for lunch.
Yeah.
What, the Osceola?
Yeah.
Well, it gives her an excuse to wear a hard hat.
Right, exactly.
either that or stop the. No, I don't know. I think the only thing with the open is what's like in the hotel.
Well, I apologize. I had a couple of shots. We started working on the next 8812 with the DOT to ask to help them.
Oh, I've got work. On my phone.
Yeah. So I had the one I sent to him. I took another one. We started yesterday morning, we got it all dug out, all the way across. We had a little issue with the river water pushing underneath and pushing up. But we got by it, we got it dug out, and put some of the road fabric paper down, and we put a stone in on top of it. Last night we finished about 5:30. And today they were starting, they were putting the pipe in. So we're hoping by tonight to have the pipe all put together and kind of set in place.
What did you do with all the cover?
We got it. Copper dam off on each side and we got pumps in there to keep the water. Yeah. So there's nothing coming in.
When do they think that's going to be done?
I would say by the time we get done with most of our work, we're working with us, but I got to come back and put our fog wells off. We got to do the blacktop, some placement back on. We'll be in a week yet anyway.
When do you say that was supposed to start? The week of July 8th?
Yes.
We haven't got an exact date yet, but it's
depending on the weather.
Whether it gets pushed out anymore.
Okay, then they'll be there for a few days. So when you find out if we can get something going, thank you.
Where are we at with the snow plow contract?
I've got a letter sitting on my desk. Got it like last week. So.
Okay, I knew that it was getting ready to get back. I thought you guys had to get together and talk.
Water finally going down enough.
So.
Finally.
Anybody else got any questions?
Other than that, CDL testing is done, and the first CDL testing Monday, I believe, from what I hear.
At the IDA building?
Yes, yeah. We talked with Don and Matt Moore of the state. They came up with their paint truck, and they actually painted the lines where they're doing the testing for them at the moment, so that worked out great. They came in with their back truck and actually backed it out. The big area swept it, and then we swept the smaller areas and picked up the rest of it. We had to cut a few trees to make it happy there, so get them more room. And I guess the last thing was we got offered another bridge. It's the Moose Creek Bridge on the East Road, just going before Greenville. It's for design only.
I mean, you got a grant?
The DOT offered to, there's so much money available for that, and we got to do for some of the $31,000, $158,000 for it. And then it makes it shelf ready. It's all designed, it's all ready, it's something on shelf. And when New York State comes out with a good amount of money, hopefully we can graduate onto that. We got two, we'll have two of them all ready to go, job ready, so. So I hope this, again, get those two ready. The other Western Gulf, West Road is one of them that we're doing right now, and Moose Creek River Bridge will do the other one. So. Any questions?
We're doing the design on Western Gulf?
We're doing a design on that one right now.
Well, I thought that was in the process to.
No, get the design done, and then it's shelf ready. And then we're hoping that, you know, be more this year, probably more year, in the next year or two, when funding available, we can get it on Bridge New York, and it's all set to go, and we can pick it up one year.
So this year is the Liberty Road Bridge, mm-hmm. And?
And the next 2020 will be the Highmark Bridge. That's complete. We'll hire that out.
Are you using concrete beams now, or are you still steel?
I'm using a steel beam job. And then they put the steel corrugated platforms down on top of one to another floor.
So it's still subject to salt road and
concrete. They designed the bigger bridges with the concrete beams and the one up in Jordan Falls.
Did he ever come back with weight and steel weights or anything?
I haven't heard any of that, no. Yeah, I don't know if he's gonna have any recourse there at all, if he wants to pursue it, you know, if we talk. Because I don't think we're gonna have any way of holding back anything. He's not a contractor, so otherwise the state would be right there, but they could show that if there was a bill came in. That's kind of unfortunate.
I think everybody's aware of it, but just to refresh, you guys took a hit. Which one? Severe weather or maintenance?
$240,000.
Okay.
We did the winter recovery money.
So, Anyway, what they thought they had to use this year, $240,000.
Watching our P's and Q's, and we're trying to get as much of them as we can, yeah. But knowing that we got that list, so we're trying to adjust for it.
Auto prices staying pretty good?
Not too bad, they haven't gone up too bad yet. We was hoping to have some of the coal mix done here next week, but we had to back it off because we just didn't get quite as much done. We've got some stone to put around the end of the culverts and things like that, just odd stuff. Some more crushed gravel. We wouldn't have had the Lines Falls Road ready. We just didn't have time to get it on before they, because they were planning on being here Tuesday, I believe.
Right.
And it just was not going to, you know, be too much rain. And no sense in getting them here and doing one road and having to come back and.
Right. We have to schedule it for the end of the month now. Yep. End of July.
So you have a few days, maybe the rest of it right now.
Yeah. Yeah.
Looks like we're gonna have a few days. So, anybody have any questions?
I do. On the CDL licensing, are you doing tractor trailers or not?
Tractor trailers.
Oh, you are gonna do it? Okay.
Last three with the tandem.
Yep, I knew you were gonna do that in the buses, but okay.
Yep, all the heavy equipment.
Great.
The one I understand, Monday or something, gonna start the first time.
Good.
I don't know how many they're gonna do. I think they're gonna start out